Hello guys, KP Shamino here with my second video for the Ember Lake. And I'm going to show you guys in this video how you need to use the marker. The marker is a very cool tool, you are going to need it. For the guys that didn't saw my first video, in that video I explained to you guys why you are going to need it, but I will do it in this video too. So first of all, it took me some time to figure it out how I need to do that stuff. So I was thinking, where do I need to get the marker? And where do I need to get the marker rod? Because I thought it was okay that you have a bottom rod. You can just put the marker on it. But that's not the case in Russian Fishing 4. You always know it's not the case. You need to buy a new rod. And they are not cheap. And that's always the same in Russian Fishing 4 too. So I bought this one. The cheapest one. Because I was thinking, if I cannot use this, because it's possible that I don't have a clue what I'm doing at some time. It's like 1000 currency that is gone. But I bought this one, you can buy the other ones. Don't ask me what is the difference. I think you can throw a little bit further, the casting distance is further. So I think that if you can throw further, that you're going to catch bigger fish in this lake. But don't ask me in detail. It's way too young, the update, to know all that stuff. So you need to buy a rod. And if you got a rod, you need to buy a marker too. And where can you find the marker? Let's have a look, because now I need to look. Rig components, marker. So here you can see it. Oh no, this is the weight. So this is the weight marker. Be sure that you got a weight that is that you can put on your marker rod. And now we need to get the float too. Where is the float? Is it here? Yeah, floats, marker. So here you can use, you can buy a float. So three of them. And then you just need to assemble them. So I will show you guys, I assembled my marker over here. So it's very easy. So you need to put it here, chains to marker rod. And I'm wondering, I was thinking maybe I can use this as a bottom rod. Because it's a very good rod, you know. So you need to put it on marker rod, marker float rig, like this. Then you put a line on it. Be sure that it's under 18 kilogram. Because I think maybe you can break a rod with the bobber. Then you put your bobber on it. And then you put your weight on it. So how does it work? So what can you do with the marker rod? It's very cool. You can see how deep it is. And you can see what kind of bottom structure that you got. And that's very good in carp fishing, because you got now lines that are the same color, for example, as clay. You got like a core feeder or a feeder core that got the same color as clay. You got the weights that got the same color as clay. So you need to match the stuff up. You need to match your rig with the environment that you're fishing. Because otherwise you're not going to catch that many fish. So let's have a look what you need to do. So first of all, I'm coming here. I don't have a clue what it is. I can see the depth here. So you just throw in the water. You close your bail. Then you reel a little bit. And now you can see the depth is 2 meters here at the left. Yeah, it's now already gone. So if you want to do it again, you just open your bail. Sometimes it's a little bit too deep. So open your bail. Because the line is, the weight is going to the bottom. So I think you got the bobber. Therefore it's a big bobber. It's like the weight is going to the bottom. And it's dragging your line down. So therefore you need to open your bail. So let's do it again. I hope it's working. Yeah, no. The bobber is going down. Let's put the bail open again. Let's have a look now. Yeah, there is it again. Depth 1.8 meter. Do you guys see it at the left? Above my boxer now, it's staying. So I'm not sure that controls works in this game to get a mouse. No, but you guys can see it. It's at the left. So how do you see what kind of bottom structure that you got? So what is it, clay? Is it sand? Is it weed? So that's very easy too. So you just do this. So I just put it on speed 5, let's say 5, and you start reeling. You can do it on higher speed too, but the main problem is that if you throw out and you clip your line for 40 meters, you got the debt, and then you start reeling in. The moment that you see what kind of bottom you got, you're already 5 to 10 meters further if you reel too fast. And that's very hard. I'm not sure there is like that you can see how many meters that you throw. I don't think so. That's a pity, because if I could now see, okay, I'm now 30 meters out, it was very easy. I just clip my car approach and it's done. So you can work a little bit around that problem. So let's start reeling now. So we are going to reel, and I hope it's working. So it takes some time. There, soil is clay. Do you guys see it? So soil is clay. I think it's going to be clay the entire way. So that's how you need to do it. So now we know this is like 1.80 meters deep, and the soil is clay. So now we can make the rig. But that's not all. So what I'm doing is this. So now I know, okay, we got this. So what I do is I clip my marker. So I go control plus minus. Let's say we go 30 meters. So 30 meters. I just throw. Okay, this is 30 meters. So let's have a look at the depth. Okay, 1.8 meters. So at 30 meters, it's 1.8 meter. We already know that. Then I just go start reeling in. Yeah, so the soil is clay. I think it's around 3 to 4 meters that I'm closer to here. So what you can do now is just throw to this. Take some time. So what I do now to get the exact, I think it's around 3 to 4 meters that you reel in until you see the structure of the ground. I don't think it matters that much, because I think your ground bait is going to influence a lot more than 3 to 4 meters. So what I'm doing now is this. So let's have a look. I just take my clip. So it was 30 meters. I just go to 35. Because the first position was 30 meters and now it's 35. So I just start reeling again in. And the moment that I'm over the 30 meters, that I know it's 1.8 meters, I will see what kind of bottom structure I got. So here we go. Soil, clay. So now I can just do this. So let's get this in. So I know now, at 30 meters, it's 1.8 meters deep, and the soil is clay. So what do you need to do now? So I will show you guys it, and why is this going so, you know what, fuck this marker rod. I just put it here, and I just go to my rigs. So what do you need to do now with the rigs? So I already got this one on. So you guys can see it here. In my first video, I set it to. So the lead core, so the lead core leader. So you guys can see the color is under the clay. It got the color of clay. So I can use it here. Don't use a wheat here or a sand one, because the bottom is not right. And then the other thing that you need to use is, I cannot now not use it because I'm using method. But if you go with another setup like this, use this. So you can see the helm van zand, rocket clay weight is clay too. So be sure that this and this is the same. So that you're using the color of the underground. So that's it. So I can take this rig now. So let's take number 2. Okay, I just put it at 30 meters. So control plus again. It's still on the old one. And then we just throw at the position. And now my setup is perfect for this. I'm not sure that the color of the leader matters. I don't think so. I don't hope so. So now you put this. So technical wise, this setup is perfect for this kind of position. That doesn't mean that you're going to catch fish. No. It's just everything that I can do the practical technical way is now okay. But if there is no fish, you're not going to catch it because the bait need to be right now too, the ground bait and all that stuff. But that's how you need to use a marker, guys. I cannot say more. Thanks for watching. Have fun. Bye-bye.